Greetings, Eric Packett, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for catching up again. We're going to talk about antibodies and Candida. Is Candida Albicans antibody screen test any good? So there are many companies that offer an antibody screening test. US Biotech, I think there's MetaMetrics, there's Diagnos-Techs Lab, there's many labs that will do it. So the three key antibodies that are screened for are IgM, IgG, and IgA. So these are produced basically by the immune system. White blood cells produce antibodies. And antibodies are exactly what they do. They are anti-something in the body, okay? So, well, they're an antibody inside the body, all right? One of the better word. So IgM antibody will, if that's quite elevated, that will signify a current or right now kind of infection, an acute infection often. So it will elevate. And as it dies down, IgG will come in as a secondary antibody. So that will start coming up and that will indicate either a past infection or an ongoing infection. So the IgM is the present, the IgG, okay, will come in a little bit later on when the initial things died down. And both of these antibodies, IgM and IgG, produce this stuff called complement. So it's a particular type of compound made by white blood cells that stimulate phagocytic activity. So basically it means that they hand-to-hand combat. It's like guys with swords, like fighting each other in these movies, you know. I just watched a movie the other day called The Patriot. I think it was pretty cool. Was it Bruce Willis or one of these American actors in it? One of these swashbuckling movies, you know, swords flying everywhere and arms dropping off. So phagocytic activity is a little bit like that. It's basically the immune system coming in there and then attacking something in the body. And that attack process is initiated by antibodies. So just remember, IgM is the primary or the initial one. And as it starts coming down, okay, the IgG will come up, which will indicate that that it's an ongoing kind of infection. IgA tends to be secreted in the digestive system more so than systemically, but also in the mouth and in mucous membranes in different parts around the body. So when IgA is elevated, it will indicate more a superficial kind of a candida infection, something a bit lighter going on in different parts of the gut. So that's the difference between the three antibody screens. Do I use them? Yeah, not really anymore. I find there are too many other factors that can influence antibody production. I find it too tedious. I find the stool test to be the definitive test, which I would use in the clinic for most patients because it offers a lot more information, a ton of information. To me, it's like looking at the weather outside and looking at the blue sky and saying, well, it's a fine day today. But hang on a minute, we didn't check the wind speed. We didn't check the barometric pressure. We didn't check the humidity. We didn't check everything about the weather to determine what's going on, okay? That's the difference between antibody testing, the blue sky, versus stool testing, which is doing a full meteorology, a weather screen. Thanks for tuning in.